Hello, friends of Immanuel Preschool. We miss you terribly, and since you cannot be here, we thought we'd bring a story to you. Like we always do when we sit at carpet of a morning, we have our story time. We're going to have our story time right here today. And our special story today is Goldilocks and the Three Bears. And here it is. It was retold and illustrated by the author Jan Brett. We've read many of her stories in the past, and we're going to read this one today. So here we go. Are you ready, friends? Are you listening? Are you focused? Goldilocks and the Three Bears. There's their snug little house all in the woods. Once upon a time, there were three bears who lived together in a house of their own in the woods in the deep, dark forest. One of them was a wee, tiny little bear. One of them was a medium-sized bear. And one was a great, huge bear. They each had a bowl for their porridge, a little bowl for the little small wee bear, a medium-sized bowl for the medium-sized bear, and a great, huge bowl for the great, huge bear. And each of them had a chair, a small one for the small wee bear, a medium one for the medium-sized bear, and a very large chair for the great, huge bear. One day, after they had made their porridge for breakfast and poured it into the bowls, they decided to go for a walk in the woods to let their porridge cool because it was very, very hot. So away they went. And while they were walking, a little girl named Goldilocks came to their house. First, she looked into the window. Then she peeked into the keyhole. Then she lifted the latch. Friends, I don't think this is a very good choice. What do you think? The door opened before her and in she went. How pleased Goldilocks was to see the steaming porridge on the table. The sweet smell of the porridge with the toasted nuts and the honey and the berries filled the room. It was so tempting that Goldilocks set about to help herself. First, she tasted the porridge of the great, huge bear. Oh my, it was much too hot. Then she tried the medium-sized bear bowl. Oh, it was just too cold. Then she tried the last bow, the wee little bow, and she tasted it, and it was just right. It was so delicious that she ate it all up. Then Goldilocks decides to walk into the bear's snug. There were three chairs. First, she sat in the very large chair. It was quite lumpy. She sat in the medium-sized chair. It was just not comfortable at all. Then she sat in the baby bear's chair, and it felt just right, and she began to rock back and forth. Ah, this feels so comfy, she thought to herself. But then she heard a crack, then a bump, then a crash, and she went to the floor, plump. Then Goldilocks decides, I wonder what other mischief I can get myself into. She saw some steps. Should she go up the steps, friends? Well, since she's going, let's just try to walk with her. Are you ready to count? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let's open the door. Are you ready? Inside, Goldilocks saw three beds. She saw a very tall bed for the very huge bear. She tried to climb up into it, but it was just too high. Then she saw a medium-sized bed. She tried to get in it, and it was just too low. Then she found a small bed, a wee bed that was probably for the tiny wee bear. She climbed up into it, she put the covers over, and she fell fast asleep. Meanwhile, by this time, the three bears thought their porridge would be cool enough. So they went into their lovely warm kitchen and they looked at the bowls. Papa Bear saw his bowl and he said in his great, gruff, huge bear voice,
Someone has been eating my porridge.
Then she looked at the mother bear, looked at the medium-sized bow. Oh dear, someone has been tasting my porridge. Then she looked at, baby bear looked at the wee small bow. And he said, well, somebody has been looking, eating my porridge, and they've ate it all gone. Next, they walked into their little snug. They had decided that someone had definitely been in the house. They looked at their chairs. Papa Bear said,
someone has been sitting in my chair.
Mother Bear said, the medium-sized bear, said, someone has been sitting in my chair because the cushions are all rumpled. Then Baby Bear looked at his chair and he began to cry. Oh, someone has been sitting in my chair, Mommy, and it's broken. So they decided we must investigate further. So they looked at the steps. Should they walk up the steps, friends? Oh, yes, I think so. So let's count again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Are you ready to open the door, friends? Upon walking into their room where their lovely three beds were, Papa Bear, in his gruff, great voice, said,
looks like someone has been sleeping in my bed.
Mother Bear said, in her medium-sized voice, well, it looks like someone has been sitting in my, or sleeping in my bed, and the covers are all wrinkled up, and I just made it up this morning. Then Baby Bear takes a look at his bed, and what does he see? He sees Goldilocks sleeping peacefully in his little bed. And he said in his wee little voice, well, somebody's been lying in my bed, and here she is. Well, Goldilocks was slumbering along, but at that very moment of hearing the wee bear's voice, she woke up and she was startled. She saw the three bears standing around her. What should she do, friends? Well, up she started and she ran to the other side of the bed. She tumbled out and ran to the window. Out Goldilocks jumped and ran as fast as she could, not looking behind her until she was very, very far away. Well, what happened to Goldilocks afterwards, no one can tell, but the three bears never saw anything of her again. The end. Friends, I hope you enjoyed our story about Goldilocks and the three bears today. And hopefully in the next few weeks, we can bring some more stories to you. In the meantime, stay safe, stay healthy, and know that everyone, all the teachers and staff here at Immanuel Preschool love you and care for you very much. And I'm going to wave goodbye and blow you a kiss. Goodbye.